Tina Turner is an instantly recognizable household name in the sphere of contemporary music. Bursting into the scene in the early 1960s, Turner has been deemed the queen of rock and roll ever since. Her career has spanned over six decades with an 11-year hiatus from 2009 to 2020. Now, upon collaborating with Kygo's remix of her classic track, What's Love Got to Do with It?, Tina Turner has re-emerged out of retirement and back into the spotlight with a new book and an upcoming documentary of her life. Born in Brownsville, Tennessee, Anna Mae Bullock entered into the world in 1939. She was the youngest child of three to her parents, Zelma Priscilla and Floyd Richard Bullock. The family were based on her father's work as a sharecropper, who had been residing in the rural location of Nutbush, Tennessee. In her early years, Turner remembered her involvement in cotton picking. Turner had to stay with her paternal grandparents for a period where her parents moved to Knoxville, splitting apart the sisters. They relocated to work in a World War II defense facility. Whilst her grandparents were strict and religiously devout, it was not long before Turner reunited with her parents and siblings in Knoxville. They all later moved back to Nutbush just in time for Turner to start elementary school. The church was a special part of Tina Turner's musical development as a young girl. She would sing as part of church choirs and find her voice. Although it seemed she was finally settled with her family, Zelma ran away from the abusive Floyd when Turner was 11. Tina Turner has documented in her autobiography that she felt unwanted and unloved by her mother, who was still young herself. When her father's remarriage saw him move over to Detroit, she and her sisters went to live with their grandmother in Brownsville. Family life up until this moment had been a source of chaos and instability. Yet as a teenager, Turner kept herself busy and enthusiastic with an array of after-school activities, such as cheerleading and basketball. She demonstrated interest in everything and loved nothing more than being social with those around her. Unfortunately, Turner's grandmother passed away when she was 16, leading her to move to St. Louis, Missouri, where her mother resided. When she had graduated, Tina Turner's first adult job was in the healthcare sector as a nurse aide. Turner continued to socialize whilst in St. Louis. Its bustling upcoming R&B scene struck her as something she was interested in, leading her to meet musician Ike Turner. Club Manhattan became the hub for Tina Turner's music discoveries, and soon enough, she would join Ike as a singer for his band, The Kings of Rhythm. Joining Kings of Rhythm in the studio, Tina Turner sang on the track A Fool in Love, and the new name, Ike and Tina Turner, was born. Under this new name, she began touring and releasing a string of singles that were extremely popular both in the R&B realm and the pop charts. They soon became an enigmatic duo who stormed through venue after venue across the US, garnering themselves a reputation for electrifying live performances and unfaltering energy. Ike and Tina Turner married in 1962, and later having a son named Ronnie, who joined three other sons from both of the previous relationship of Ike and Tina. For the rest of the decade, Tina and the group found themselves with fairly popular reception on their R&B singles. They continued touring and changed labels numerous times during the course of the decade. A few of the songs the two wrote together became solo singles for Tina Turner, who then featured on television and began establishing a solo image too. Iconic record producer Phil Spector caught wind of Turner's talent and arranged a deal to have control of her sessions by paying $20,000 to Loma, the label that currently owned Ike and Tina. In the professional relationship with Spector, the duo found a new level of stardom. The album River Deep, Mountain High was released in 1966 and saw huge charting success in the UK, reaching the top five. However, it took another 4 years for it to strike with American audiences, and the duo spent the last couple of years of the 60s appearing on television and embarking on a tour with the Rolling Stones, which they opened for. 1971 marked one of the most iconic releases of Tina Turner's career, Proud Mary. Initially a song by the band Creedence Clearwater Revival, Ike and Tina Turner brought a completely different sound to the song. Its energy started off uncharacteristically slow, but by the end was full of their classic funk soul energy. full of brilliant charting figures, the single received a Grammy Award for Best R&B Vocal Performance by a Group. Proud Mary has remained a hugely popular song, which Tina Turner has re-recorded for her future solo work. Whilst some of the biggest success was occurring by the mid-1970s, there were also simmering tensions occurring between Ike and Tina personally. This later resulted in both a divorce of their marriage and of the band. Unfortunately, Tina Turner experienced several years of struggling with money and lack of solo attention, but she continued playing live in smaller venues. In 1983, Turner released a cover of Al Green's Let's Stay Together, which marked the start of her epic comeback. A solo album, Private Dancer, followed and received a massive amount of praise and attention. There was miraculous anticipation for Turner as a solo artist, which evidently revealed itself in the sales of her solo work since. While she was approaching her middle age years, Tina Turner remained just as fiercely energetic on stage as she did back in her duet days. The sheer amount of attention led to film features including Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome and the documentary Tina Turner, Girl from Nutbush. Altogether, Tina Turner has released 10 studio albums over her career. Additionally, she served vocals for iconic film songs including the James Bond theme, GoldenEye, and He Lives in You for The Lion King 2. Her final tour, entitled Tina 50th Anniversary Tour, commenced between 2008 and 2009 and was one of the best-selling tours of the year. And although she is now retired, Tina Turner is an artist who remains prevalent in music. She is an inspiring example of true ups and downs enduring a career that faltered in its middle. Her vocals are especially iconic, demonstrating a contralto voice type which is both husky and full of seductive soul. And as an African-American woman, Tina Turner emerged in an environment that would undermine her. However, even when the industry failed her, Turner stepped back and achieved heights that no one could have ever guessed.
You can check out the Carly of Spotify to listen to the original tracks of the artist. It's a curated playlist with the most popular songs.